I have sensorineural hearing loss in both ears. It was something that I was born with. Growing up, I did rely on various pieces of assistive technology, and that kind of always led me motivated to want to go into this field and be able to make a difference.
I'm Laura D'Aquila, and I'm a software engineer on Google Docs, Sheets, and Slides accessibility.
We are completely focused on accessibility for the different products that we work on. I'm Abigail Klein, and I'm a software engineer on Google Chrome accessibility. We do a lot of things related to accessibility and trying to learn about our users and what will make the experience the most accessible experience possible. We work with people who have disabilities, so we can learn from them firsthand on what are some of the challenges that they face.
So because of my hearing loss, sometimes when I would be in meetings or other types of presentations at work, it can be a little bit more difficult for me to follow along. It depends a lot on the particular audio setup of the room and whether a microphone is used. And there were like a couple of situations where I would actually be at a presentation, but I would just find that it wasn't worth my time to be there because of the audio setting. And as a result, I would leave some of those presentations early.
We realized that maybe we could use some of the technology that Google had already built for speech to text. That's already being used for the Google Assistant and for other products. So we realized, hey, we could use that technology to build captions that somebody could use during a presentation. And then maybe that would help Laura and other people like her be able to follow along. We are really fortunate that our team has a hackathon every 6 months. Basically what it is it's an opportunity for developers, UX, PM to put aside their regular jobs and just work on whatever they feel like working on. The fact that we were able to build the prototype in a week demonstrated that, hey, we could build this whole thing at a production level quality and be able to deploy it pretty quickly. So this is definitely worth us investing in and actually building out.
The particular API that Abigail and I had used for slides captions, that's Google's Cloud Speech API. It's publicly available. It's free to get started with, and you can easily hook that up into any application you might be working on that needs voice input or captioning or any other type of speech-to-text application. We had a user experience researcher that we worked with, and this researcher showed prototypes of the feature to actual users, and from there we iterated on feedback that we received. One of the great pieces of feedback that we received was just the fact that this feature can be so useful not only for those who are deaf or hard of hearing, but also just everybody who's in the presentation.
My name is Martin Cisneros. I'm an academic technology specialist here with the Santa Clara County Office of Education. When I first learned about closed captioning for Google Slides, I thought it was a huge game changer. So with closed captioning, being an educator for English language learners has always been a push of how can I find technology that will enhance their development in language. One of my thoughts was like, well, just grab a slide, put the topic on, you know, at the very top, and put the essential question on the bottom. What are you talking about? And then just hit play, hit closed captioning, and let that be a different way of using the tool. You are gonna have your students who are English language learners who that's gonna benefit, and that's a great one. You have your other kids who have hard of hearing, that's gonna be beneficial as well. If you are already an outstanding teacher and you want to enhance your reach with students, technology like this can really benefit not only your students, but your whole community, your whole learning community as well.
If you're able to position yourself or meet people who have a lot of diverse perspectives from yourself, put yourself out there, try to meet people who are really different from you, and then you can really learn about, as Laura was saying, hey, how would somebody use my product if they can't see it, if they can't type on the keyboard?
There's never just going to be a one-size-fits-all answer for accessibility. There are many, many different types of disabilities. Oftentimes, some people might have multiple disabilities, and it's just so important to be working directly with these communities to make sure that you're building something that can actually be useful. So we were confident in what we launched would be helpful to our users.